Very good morning, my dear students. Today you are going to learn the masking techniques. Here the masking techniques. The diagram is given here, and the masking techniques is a definition which is they will introduce the noise in the NTE notes for purpose of eliminating the cross hearing. So here the making means. One that put in some noise in the opposite ear while testing an ear. So the reason to do this is to prevent the sound from the side being tested from going over the good side. So this is called the crossover problem. You see the diagram here, which is example for crossover problem. So when to do the masking here? So when we have to go for masking, bone conduction testing in a person with the hearing loss should be done with the masking to prevent the sound from the stimulated side from going over to good side. Here the air conduction testing should be done when there is a 40 dB or a greater threshold have been obtained. So what is the method of masking here? So if the one is done doing the pure tone testing, the masking signal should be narrow band noise centered on the test frequency. If one is doing the speech, one should use the speech noise. So the masking is not always needed when doing an air conduction audiogram. So these crossover problem occurs to different extended depending on the air bones being used. The air bones that go around the ear run into crossover problem when the sound is about 40 dB or louder. The air bones that go into the ear, that is inserted in inner ear, have a problem at about 60 dB. Thus, if the ears are both normal, masking is no need required. One should always mask the air conduction if there is a 40 dB or greater threshold. For bone conduction testing, the sound should be goes both ears, and one cannot test one ear by itself usually without using the masking. The best strategy therefore for bone conduction testing is to always mask. So here this is the person is completely deaf on the right side. However, the because masking was not used, the bone lies make it appears they could not have a normal hearing. So when the masking is not used, one may incorrectly which conclude there is a better hearing in a bad ear. Then is really the case. Because without masking, some of the sound is actually appreciated by the good ear. So masking dilemma, that is what is the masking dilemma, we are going to see that here. So this is the situation occurs when there is a conductive type of hearing loss in both ear, which is moderate to severe. The dilemma is that an adequate intensity to the mask, the non-test ear crosses over the testing ear and invalidates the thresholds. Enough masking is too much masking. There are several works around to do this one. When one is masking air conduction, if one can that is no performance that means uses in that is inside the air ports. So other method include using the board ABR testing. ABR is unaffected by the central effect of masking, but the sound is still stimulates both ear, and also one is limited by the one's bone stimulator. Another method is SAL, that is sensorineural acuity level techniques. So in SAL method, both ears are masked equally through the an oscillator which is placed over the forehead. This is done by performing an air conduction threshold using bone masking. Then they are doing some adjustment for the air conduction shift. This shift involves a large number of subtractions of the noise value, and for this reason seems to be a intrinsically unreliable method. Here the bottom line is that when the one encounters the masking dilemma, usually this is simply noted on the audiogram, and one accept that if it is impossible to determine the detail of hearing losses. And you are seeing here this diagram is same as the person above that tested this time with the masking. Here it is clear that the patient cannot hear on the right side. This is the correct result which is shown in the diagram. Thank you very much for listening to class.